a year ago this upcoming weekend, there was a tragic shooting in Bob Baskin Park that took the lives of two young males who really never got their life started. And it's tragic in a way on how it occurred and even why it occurred. It stemmed from a party, a house party, that occurred several miles away from where the shooting took place. And in the interim, when the first party broke up, there was a lot of texting that went on between the individuals at this party. The texting ultimately led to or was contributory part of the shooting itself that occurred at Bob Baskin. Not that the individuals that were killed or shot were the intended victims. They were just in the wrong place at the wrong time. But because of the texting that took place and because of some of the things that transpired because of the texting, two young individuals died. And that's tragic and it's preventable. So I guess the message I'd like to get out today is be a friend to a friend or have your friends back. Do the right thing for your friends. They're your friends. So hopefully you value your friends enough to take care of them. And what I'm speaking of, the texting obviously is one problem. And what's occurred, this year alone there's been 8 incidents that involved weapons or shootings at parties, all stemming from texting. And normally what occurs is you invite your friends over for a party, they text the invitation to a friend who texts it to another individual who texts it to another friend. Next thing you know, you have uninvited people showing up at your party. And you can classify some of these people, if you want, as thugs. And they're bringing weapons. They're unwanted. And next thing you know, they're in your house unwanted. That's not what you want to do when you have a party. And that's never the intended idea of the party, but that's just where it's been going to. There's 13 of them last year. So obviously there is a problem in this valley with texting parties and the texting emails and the invitations. So be a friend to a friend or have your friends back and don't do that. You call your friends up, you schedule with your friends. I mean, we all know we can get our message across. We don't have to do it this way. Be a friend of your friend too. Don't let friends bring weapons. Don't let your friends have weapons. It's probably not a good idea that your friends do have weapons, but don't do it at parties. Alcohol, drunk driving. There's a lot of factors that go into taking care of your friends, having some responsibility for your friends. They're your friends. Obviously, they mean something to you. Don't let your friends get in a vehicle drunk after a party. Again, there's been enough tragic loss of life in this valley that we've seen over the past several years and over the term of my career where people get in the cars drunk and their lives are snuffed out before they reach the age of 20 years old. What the parents can do to assist, and this is what we've been speaking of for the past, over the past year now, talk to your kids. That's probably the most important thing you can do is have dialogue with your kids. Know where your kids are at. Know what your kids are doing. Take an active part in your kid's life. It's your kid. And that's, you know, it's a responsibility that all parents have with their children is to protect their children. And, you know where your kids are at. Know who their friends are. Know what's in their backpack. Know what's in their room. They're your kids. It's your house. It's your family. The texting. Know what your kids are doing with the texting. The computers. Look at their websites. Where are they at on the computers? What are they doing? So take an active interest in your kids. And when we're speaking of kids, I mean, we look at a lot of children, and they are children. 11, 12, 13-year-old children going to parties. House parties is not a good thing. And I think most parents would not find that acceptable that you have youngsters going to parties where you have gang members, you have weapons, you have drugs, you have alcohol. I don't think as a parent you'd really find that acceptable or something that you would encourage your kids to attend. So that is definitely one way I think a parent could be active in keeping their kids safe. Another thing too, and a big issue, is teen driving, teen drunk driving. Because the kids go to these parties, they get in a car, they're drunk, and they take off with 4 or 5 of their friends, and next thing you know, you have a tragic crash. And this has been played out many times at the end of the school year because everybody's graduating, it's party time, everyone wants to have a good, go out and have a good time, mix some liquor into that and some irresponsible driving, and people die. And this has occurred every year. We see an uptrend in the amount of DUI accidents that occur involving youngsters. And again, like I brought up before, be a friend to a friend. Take your friend's keys away. Pull your friend aside and say, just don't do it. Find alternative way for them to get home or you know, call parents or whatever you need to do. Just make sure you and your friends all get home in one piece. Curfew on the weekends is at midnight, and during the weekdays is at 10 o'clock. And that's on the strip also. The strip's at 10 o'clock. And this is all part of the PASS program, or the Safe Schools program, is from what we do, from law enforcement, is definitely a very ramped up presence at the schools, because we want to get that message out. This press conference is a good tool right here. We've been much more successful working as partners with the media to get that message out to people, and not only to the kids, but to the parents themselves, because they're an integral part of this whole problem. I mean, the parents have a lot to do with this. We can't do this without the parents, but we want to make the kids aware. We want to make people aware. We want to make people think. And I think that's been a major change over the past 2 years, is more of getting the message out, getting out often, getting it out early. This year has been the least violent school year we have ever encountered. We had several shootings last year. This time last year, we had several shootings, not to include the Bob Baskin Park shooting. This year so far, that has not occurred. And we have found that has been a joint effort between law enforcement, parents, the school district, the media. A lot of people have gone in to make this successful. And a lot of it I attribute to making people more aware of what the problem is, making people think before they do things.